Many Canadians are familiar with the colorful dresses, the elaborate beadwork, and the harmonies of Kenya's Maasai people. A group in Saskatoon, though, wants people to know this culture is under attack. They say it's similar to Canada's residential school experiment, where tens of thousands of Indigenous children were forced to abandon their families, their home, and their culture. Similarly, Maasai people are being sent to small reserves by the Kenyan government. In their schools, they are prohibited from speaking their native language and they're forced to wear school uniforms. The Kenyan government says these measures are necessary to bring the Maasai into the modern world. But a Maasai man living in Saskatoon says any education system should respect their culture.
The Maasai kind of going into through like a transition of life changing, and they want to going through a transition, going into needing another sort of education, how to live and survive. So it's when I talk about education, it's not only like for learning how to read, but learning how to survive.
Salash and others in Saskatoon started the Ultumo project several years ago. They've raised money to build a large community garden and offer public health services. But the ultimate goal is to build a Maasai school. Elders and locals would teach the standard curriculum, but they do it in the local language with local traditions integrated. Salash and others will continue fundraising in Saskatoon and plan to return to Ultumo in the coming months. If all goes well, the Maasai will continue to sing, dance, and speak their native language for generations to come. Jason Warwick, CBC News, Saskatoon.